Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, our God. Thank you, the Ancient of Days, the King of Kings, the God in whose name and power all things are possible. Father, we have come to you through this prayer, and we are seeking your face, and we know that indeed, according to Jeremiah 2, number 13, that we shall see your face. That as we seek you, we shall see you. We shall encounter you. We shall experience your finger in our lives, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the first stage of this prayer that you have used to prepare us for this 3-day prayer for financial breakthrough for your children. And Father, we thank you because we know that heaven is waiting for a day like this, that your children shall pray and this shall happen. Father, the hour has come. We lift our hearts to you. Father, touch us one by one in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord, fill us with thy fire and with thy power, and let your presence be overwhelming in the course of this prayer. May we experience the touch of your hand, O God, in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, every sin we have committed by our thoughts, by our actions, or by our inactions, Father, we ask for mercy and we ask for forgiveness for all the ways we have rebelled against you. Father, be merciful, O Lord. Thank you, Father, because we know that having asked for forgiveness of our sins, that indeed you have forgiven us. Blessed be your name, in the name of Jesus. And so we lift up our hands to heaven and we call upon the glory of God to come down upon each and every one of us in the course of the prayer. Let this prayer provoke blessings upon somebody's family, provoke blessings upon everyone hearing my voice right now, in the name of Jesus. Father, the hour has come. Have mercy on us according to your loving kindness. And let it be said tonight that your river of blessings shall flow into the territories of your people, blessing them mightily, watering the gardens that have been barren or lands that have been dry. Father, may there be water tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. Jesus, we are inviting all the angels and saints and even the 24 elders in heaven to come and be with us in this prayer as the Almighty God, Father and Son, and Holy Spirit prevails over this prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. My dear friends, I have the pleasure to welcome every one of us to the House of Jesus and Mary Ministries. This is a ministry that want to see you succeed, that want to see you be who God have created you to be. Every day we share the word of God and we pray simply because we know and we believe in the power of the word of God. We believe that God created the whole world by his spoken word. And we believe that that spoken word is also at work in our lives. And so as we use the word of God in prayer, as we often do, we recreate the environment. We recreate the little world that God has given to us to occupy. We create things we want to see through the word of God. And also, we know that God is here, resident with us, that we pray and he answers us. And we know that if there are people to pray, there is a God to answer. And that God is here with us today to honor the prayers of his children, that as we pray with the word of God will also, through his word, honor his word, and then bless you. And so I pray in the course of these 3 days prayers that God will empower you, bless you, and decorate you with his mighty series of blessings in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And so, my people of God, the purpose of this prayer, this 3-day prayer, is to ask God for financial breakthrough. Now, we need God to bless us so that we can be blessing to others. Many people of God are living in shambles. They want to bless people, they want to bless the church, but because they are not blessed, then they cannot be able to bless the ministry of Jesus. And today we are seeking the face of heaven to bless us financially. God says, ask and you shall receive. The messages we have been given, or God has been leading us in this ministry, is centered on the word. It's centered on praying, intercessory prayer. God honors the prayers of intercession. But a time comes when you also have to pray for yourself. And that's what we'll do today, to pray for ourselves, for the members of the ministry, for financial breakthrough. We have been so generous in praying for people, praying for the world, for governments, for families, praying over societal problems. But today we are going to pray for ourselves. And indeed, God will honor our prayers in the name of Jesus. Now, many people begin to wonder, oh, is it right to pray for wealth? Is it right to pray for financial breakthrough? Is that not contravening the word of God in 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 10, where the Bible says that the love of money is the root of all evil? My dear friends in Christ, indeed, the love of money is the root of all evil. And yet, God gives money. But when we allow the love of money, not that is worshiping money, that is placing money above God, making money your God, the hand of God is not there. But can God give wealth? Yes, of course. Remember, David was not considered as a poor man. Neither was Solomon considered a poor man. God gave superlative wealth to Solomon. Now, just to make it clear, the Bible tells us in Psalm 11, verse 1 to 3, that wealth and the riches are for those that fear the Lord. In other words, God gives wealth and God gives riches. These are the blessings that God could and would give. And even as this message is going on, I remember one of my friends many years ago, we used to belong to the same ministry back home in Nigeria, and every weekend we go and spend the weekend praying in a ministry. And then one day he had a dream. And he called me and said, "Oh, Brother Wabwe, I don't know what's happening to my life. I had a dream. And this dream, somebody who was like an archbishop gave him a money that was too staggering. You know, I still remember when he was talking of billions of the country's currency. And he said, "Look, I don't know this kind of dream. It seems that I'm having some malaria." I started laughing at him. And I said, "My friend, you better claim that dream, because God came to you in the form of an archbishop to give you such a sumptuous blessing, and you have to claim it." And he was laughing. He never believed that it was something serious to pray for or to harvest by way of claiming it. However, some few years later, I traveled out of my country, and we lost touch for some time. And then by the time we're reconnecting again, it would be an understatement to describe him as a wealthy man. I mean, he was so rich, so wealthy that I don't know how to describe it for you here so you understand what I'm talking about. What marveled me was that the speed at which he grew was amazing. And I told him, I said, "Do you still remember when God was talking about this? You remember when you said it was a malaria disturbing you? I asked you to pray that we cancel the spirit of malaria." And we laughed over it. And today, he keeps churches, ministries, he blesses people in such big way, in such a very big way. And he does it because God has blessed him. That is it. You know, because God has blessed him, then he cannot be a blessing to others. And that's what God wants to do in the course of the prayer. He wants to bless you so that you will be a blessing to others, a blessing to his ministry. Amen? Now, then the ministry that we belong to that time, I mean, he has been very, very highly supportive of that ministry, financially supportive of the ministry. And I am so thankful to God for him. Just I'm talking about how God blessed him financially. I also remember another revelation that came that period. Okay. He happened to marry, but he never had a child. He never had a child. It was about 13 years. I think between 12 and 13 years that he eventually got a child. Now, but this was a revelation that Lord gave many years back when I was still with him. But years passed, nothing to show at the end of the day. But God, in the fullness of his time, now opened the womb of the wife, and she conceived. And I remember when he came to the United States, and then he called me and said, "Brother, we're here to for my wife to have a baby here in this country." And we talked and talked into the late night, and we reviewed, talked about the past, how God revealed these things. And it took time before it came to pass. And my dear friends, I don't know what God has revealed to you, but what I tell you tonight is that that God who reveals will also redeem. He will also fulfill. He will never abandon you. Hearken unto his word, hearken unto his promises. That God is a faithful God. The God who did it for our brother, that God will also do something for you. I want to leave you with the word of God of Hebrews 1, verse 12. And the Bible says that you will roll them up like a robe, like a garment, they will be changed. But you remain the same, and your years will never end. Our God remained the same. Our God will never change. Everything will change. Even human promises will fail, will change, but not our God. God is not man that changeth. He's not man that faileth. Has he given you promise or promises? And I tell you, that God will fulfill the promise that he has made for you. And I pray tonight that that God will visit you and bless you tonight in a mighty way. That in the course of this prayer, may God reveal himself to you. May God open the vessels of heaven to bless you in the name of Jesus. And Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 12, and the Bible says that indeed the Lord is watching to see that his word is fulfilled in your life. That promise that God has given to you is going to be fulfilled. God is a God who blesses his own people. Once upon a time, there was a man called Isaac, and God blessed him in a foreign land. And I want to start this message with the scripture of Genesis chapter 26, verse 12 to 13. Genesis chapter 26, verse 12 to 13. Let us pray. Mighty God, as we're about to listen to your word, we're asking you to use your word to bless our souls, to enlighten our minds, to understand you divinely under the power of your holy name. This we pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Genesis chapter 26, verse 12 to 13. Genesis chapter 26, verse 12 to 13. And the Bible says, Isaac sowed seed in that land, and in the same year, he reaped a hundredfold. The Lord blessed him. And verse 13 says, and the man became rich. He prospered more and more until he became very wealthy. And the Bible says, it is so because God was with him. And this is the gospel, the word of the Lord. Thanks be to you, Lord Jesus. My dear friends in Christ, we know the story of Abraham. God bless Abraham indeed. Indeed. All right? Now, the son of Abraham, being Isaac, happened to be blessed indeed. Now, who blessed him? God. God made the Abraham very wealthy. God made Isaac, his son, very wealthy. God blessed them in a way that in the city or in the city of Gerar, God blessed Isaac to the extent that every seed he planted or sowed in the land was able to give a hundredfold a blessing, a hundredfold favor, a hundredfold harvest. This was what God did for this man. And I pray for you that the God of Isaac, the God who gives multiple fold of harvest to whatever thing that is sown in the land, may that God bless you. Whatever seed you have sown in this ministry and in other ministries or in the Church of Christ Jesus, I pray that God will remember that seed today in the name of Jesus. I pray for you that what God did for Isaac, that he may do it for you. That every seed you have sown in the land, may there be reaped a hundredfold. May there be reaped a thousandfold. May there be reaped a millionfold in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and begin to pray now. I am praying blessings unto your hand. I am praying blessings unto your hands. That is what I have come here to pray in the name of Jesus. That your hands shall be loaded. That somebody shall carry heavy duty blessings in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, may God load you with grace. May he load you with blessings. May he bless you until you become very blessed. This was the favor that God gave to Isaac in Genesis 20, verse 13. And the Bible says, and Isaac became very rich. He prospered more and more until he became very wealthy. And I'm praying for you that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom I serve, may the anointing to grow and to prosper come upon you. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. May you prosper from grace to grace, from strength to strength, from wealth to greater wealth. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Every power holding down your blessings, may God scatter them tonight. May God fight them tonight. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, I pray that God will prosper you more and more, that you will grow more and more in handling power of finances in the name of Jesus. May God bless you until you become very wealthy in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, Father, touch your people again. That hour has come, O Lord. Who can make your people great if not you? Who can expand your people if not you? In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, Father, prosper your people. Father, prosper your people. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, every power that is standing against what you want to do for my life through prayer. Yes, my Lord. Let such powers scatter. Let such powers catch fire by the power of your holy name. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, I declare this season a season of open doors, a season of prosperity, a season of financial increase in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, Father, bless me. Holy Spirit, bless me. I need your blessing, O Lord, by the power of your holy name, in the name of Jesus. Jesus, open your mouth and pray. Call on him, call on him, call on him. Let him bless you tonight. Let him touch you tonight. Let him empower you tonight to handle a new blessing in your life, in the name of Jesus. Talk to him, talk to him. Ask him to increase you mightily. Ask him to expand you mightily. Oh, Jesus, in a time of Jabez, oh, God enlarge his coast. May God enlarge your coast tonight in the name of Jesus. In Psalm 107, verse 38, and the Bible says that God blessed them greatly. He expanded them greatly. He increased their blessings mightily. He multiplied them greatly until they became very great. And they did not suffer diminish. They did not suffer decrease. They never went down. Their cattle were increasing, never decreasing. I am praying for you. May your cattle never decrease. May your children never decrease. May your blessings never decrease. You shall be a great nation. In the name of Jesus, may the Lord make you a great nation. Yes, my Lord. It does. Father, make your people a great nation. Let them lend it to nations. And the Bible says in Psalm 2, verse 8, ask me, and I will make the nations your inheritance. Ask me, and I will make the nations your inheritance. Oh, Jesus, can you begin to ask him now? Make the nations my inheritance. Give me the inheritance of the nations, that I may begin to lend to nations. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Father, touch us, O Lord. Father, fill us, O Lord, with your fire. Fill us with your power. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Father, the hour has come. The hour to increase. In the name of Jesus. Father, enlarge your people again. We need you, O Lord. Oh, Jesus. Father, even in Genesis chapter 12, verse 2, your word says, I will make you into a great nation. The same word your word says in Psalm 2, verse 8, and you shall be great, and I shall make you to lend to nations, and you shall be great, and you shall have the nation's inheritance. Father, let it happen again. Bless your people, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. We are asking for financial breakthrough, Papa. Father, expand the horizons of your people. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Father, O Lord, in Genesis 12, verse 2c, and your word says, and I will make your name great, so that you be a blessing. Father, this blessing you gave to Abraham, let this blessing be extended to every one of us, O Lord. Make our name great. My name shall be great. Papa, make my name great. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Father, make me to be blessed, superlatively blessed, in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Pray now, my people. Pray now, my people. There is nothing that God cannot do. Yes, my Lord. You remember the man called Ishmael, that even though he was a son of a slave girl, yet God, out of his mercy, blessed Ishmael and told him in Genesis 17, verse 20, that I have indeed heard you, and I will surely bless you. I will surely make you fruitful, and I will multiply you greatly, and you shall become father of many. Oh, Jesus, and I will make you a great nation. Do you know that this was a promise that God made, even to a seed of Abraham, that was not even in a heir to Abraham? We know the story how Ishmael came into the family of Abraham. He was not a promised son. And yet, look at the way God blessed him. What can God not do for you? That God who blessed Ishmael, even though that he was not a promised child, that God is about to do it for you. In the name of Jesus. And I pray for you that God will make you great in the name of Jesus. May God expand you. May God make you fruitful. May you be fruitful. And may you multiply in greatness. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. In Exodus chapter 1, verse 7, the Bible says that God increased the Israelites until they became very fruitful. And they increased abundantly. Hey! May God bless you, expand you abundantly, make you fruitful abundantly. May He multiply you abundantly, exceedingly, in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. May He make you exceedingly strong, stronger than any power that wants to hold down your finances, in the name of Jesus. I am praying that this season of this prayer shall take you to a season of abundance, a latter rain of abundance, a heavy rain of abundance. May God flood your life with the mighty blessings, in the name of Jesus. May He fill your barns with mighty blessings, in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. And the Bible tells me to tell you in Deuteronomy chapter 1, verse 10, that the Lord your God has multiplied you so that today you are so numerous as the stars in the sky. May that star of the sky be your position. May God expand you. Make your blessings to be too numerous. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Father, touch your people. The Bible says, Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 14, you will be blessed above all peoples. Among you, there shall be no barren man or woman or livestock. Oh, Jesus, you spirit of barrenness, making me to be barren of blessings,
making my blessing to disappear or to miscarry, today be destroyed by fire. For the Bible says in Deuteronomy 7 verse 14 that I have been blessed above all people. I have been blessed above poverty. I have been blessed above barrenness in the name of Jesus. And nothing in my family shall miscarry. My children shall not miscarry. They shall not miscarry their blessings in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, Father, take over, O Lord. Holy Ghost, take over. Sanctify us again in the name of Jesus. What you did for Isaac, O Lord, may you do it for me. What you did for Isaac, Papa, Papa, do it for your people. You gave your word in Psalm 11, verse 1 to 3, that wealth and riches are for those who fear you. Father, we fear you. Therefore, bless us, O Lord. Bless us with your wealth. Bless us with riches. For good things coming from you, from above, from the kingdom of light, in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Father, take over. In the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. So, my dear people of God, God wants to bless us. It is God's desire to see his children move in great authority, even to be distributors of wealth. He did it for Abraham, he did it for Isaac, he did it for Jacob, and he wants to do it for you. God wants to see you go beyond living paycheck to paycheck. One of the ways the devil attacks the church is to make sure that people's hands are tied so that they will not be blessing the church. They will not be blessing the ministry of God. Many people have the mind to sow big in God's ministry. But the devil comes after them to attack their wealth, to attack their resources, so that they will not be able to fulfill their promises. Many have made promises to God, but they're not fulfilling it because they don't have it. In this ministry, people have promised God, God, I'm making this pledge to support this ministry. I am going to be sowing seed into the ministry. I'm going to support the secretariat project. But they don't have the resources to fulfill it. They are under attack. I shared it with you some time ago, how the Lord gave me a startling revelation, and I saw my eyes open, and I saw a meeting going on in the sea, in the river. I saw mansions, gold everywhere, golden boardroom. So difficult to explain. And this was forces of darkness holding their meetings. And the secretary was called to announce the agenda for the day. And I hear the secretary saying, the agenda of today is how to attack people who are using their gifts to serve God. And they listed names. Number one, Wapwechukwu. You see that? And when this thing happened, I didn't even know that that I was called into ministry. I didn't even know that there was something God wants to use me to do. This was even before ministry started. So even that revelation wasn't making me need to be that time. But now when I look back, I can now see that the devil had already seen the star and came to fight. He has called me to be a minister. That's a gift he has given to be his minister, to minister to people, to bless people in his name. And that's what I've come today to do in your life, because God has blessed me with a gift to bless you. Every man of God carries a blessing to change people's misery, to change people's ugly situations. And I want to exercise and steer that anointing today, that you shall be blessed to be a blessing to others, to your parishes,
to the ministry of Christ.
Called me into ministry to minister. He may have called you to be ministering through songs. He may call another person to be supporting ministry through finances. People are gifted different ways. I've never read the Bible where Isaac was cursing and biting the devil. But you see him being blessing to others because God has blessed him materially. It's a blessing, it's a gift. And so in this prayer, I am asking heaven to raise an altar of wealth. When you are blessed, I am blessed. Every father wants to see his children blessed. I want to see you blessed. I want to see you prosper. That is what gives me joy, is that there is a result of prayers made in this ministry. When people are giving their testimonies, it pleases me. You have no clue how it pleases me to hear your testimonies. And so since the Lord has instructed me to bless, so I will bless. Oh my goodness. That reminds us of Numbers chapter 23 verse 20. And the Bible says, "Behold, I have received an instruction, a command, a mandate to bless. He has blessed, and I cannot reverse it." You know what I'm talking about? That God has mandated me to bless you, and I cannot withhold it. I cannot revoke it. I cannot delay it. And so be blessed in the name of Jesus. In the morning and the night, be blessed. May your well be blessed. May your garden be blessed. May your family be blessed. May your career be blessed. Everything you do, may blessing flow like a river. Oh, Jesus. May you be blessed to the level that people will know that indeed you are blessed. You see, there's a level of pregnancy a woman will get to. She cannot hide that pregnancy again. When that pregnancy was two weeks old, she could hide it. Okay? She might go and hide somewhere. The morning sickness may come. And she will just hide in the room and hide and wouldn't like people to know. In the morning, she will explain the morning sickness. But by afternoon, she should be at work. Nobody will know. But there's the level the pregnancy will get to. She can't hide it. She can't wear whatever thing she wants to wear. She can't wear that tight. You see her dressing changing. You see her body changing. Everything is changing. And even those who are blind will see that indeed this person is loaded. I am praying for you that nations, people will know that indeed you are loaded in the name of Jesus. That you shall be loaded with the blessings. That you shall carry heavy duty favor tonight in the name of Jesus. Let the Holy Spirit overshadow you. Bless you in a way that you can't contain it. It overflow. Those of you who have been carrying poverty like a garment, God shall deliver you in the course of this prayer. I say God shall deliver you in the course of this prayer in the name of Jesus. So we are praying for financial breakthrough. I don't know how long or how many years will make the kind of prayer last. It usually don't. This may be the third time we're making the entire history of this prayer meeting or ministry. Because our focus is on intercessory prayer, praying for people, listening to the word of God. But today it is to pray for financial breakthrough. You have been waiting on the Lord for this miracle. May God grant you your heart desires.
that is according to his will, in the name of Jesus.
Maybe you are feeling that your finances have been cursed. As we go through these 3 days of prayer, every curse against your finances must expire. Every curse against your finances must catch fire. Every curse against your finances must destroy it now, in the name of Jesus. Every curse against your finances, let there is the Holy Ghost fire, in the name of Jesus. As we go through these prayers, we are going to stand upon God's word. We are going to depend on the word of God to change situations. It is not God's will for us to live in despair. It is God's will that we shall live victoriously, walking on the waters, never sinking into poverty, into shame, into despair. But it's God's will that we shall prosper and be in good health, financial health, economic health, and all that, even clinical health. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. We need to know the will of God concerning our lives. And those needs shall be met according to his glory. Philippians chapter 4, verse 19 is our prayer point now. That we are standing upon Philippians 4, verse 19, which states that my God will meet my needs according to the riches of his glory in Christ Jesus. I thank you, Father, that I do not have to put trust in my abilities to meet my needs, but I put my trust in your ability to effectively walk through me to bring my dreams to come to pass according to your will, according to your riches in glory, in the name of Jesus. And so I pray now that every power of the enemy standing against the will of God for your life, let such a power of the enemy be destroyed now, in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. And I pray that, ask God, that every seed of lack be destroyed in your life, in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, as we seek the Lord, we shall discover him. We shall find him. If you seek the Lord, you will find him. You will lack no good thing. And so as we seek him in the course of the prayer, we shall not lack blessings, in the name of Jesus. And the Bible says, in Psalm 34, verse 10, the lions may grow weak, and they may even grow hungry, but those who seek the Lord shall lack no good thing. That is the word of God. And so we stand upon Psalm 34, verse 10, Heavenly Father, that declares, the lion may grow weak and hungry, but those who seek the Lord shall lack no good thing. Lord Almighty, therefore, we seek your face, and we are believing that we are not going to lack anything good. We're not going to lack financial breakthrough and blessings, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, therefore, may you touch us in a special way. Bless us in a special way. Fortify us, O God, in the name of Jesus. We know that the lions may grow hungry, but not your children, because your word says, you shall not detach from us any good thing. You shall not take away from us anything that is good. Father, O Lord, come and take over. O Jesus, the hour has come. And the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 13, verse 22, O Jesus, a good man leaves an inheritance for his children's children, but sinner's wealth is stored up for the righteous. And so, Father Almighty, we are believing you, O Lord, by your word as you have spoken now in Proverbs 13, verse 22, that every creative idea be revealed to your people. That even in our dreams, Father, give us creative ideas, that we open the doors of creativity, of inheritance, in the name of Jesus. Father, we are believing in you for creative ideas and opportunities to build wealth in order to leave a legacy for our children and even children. I don't want to leave them poor. I don't want to leave them beggars. Father, O Lord, bless me that I shall be blessed to them. Give me inspiration, heavy duty favor. Father, that hour has come. Only you that can do this, O Lord. Give me, O Lord, creative ideas. Oh, business ideas that will be harvested, that will create opportunities to build wealth in a way to leave legacy for the church, for the ministry of Christ, for my family, for my children, for the society, for the poor. Father, O Lord, bless me that I shall be a blessing to the poor. Father, bless me that I shall be a blessing to future generations, even to my own generation. Give me a blessing that is intergenerational. Give me a blessing that is intergenerational. Father, the blessing you gave to Abraham was not a generation for his own generation. It was a blessing for intergenerational order. Father, Lord, he was blessed. Even Isaac was blessed. Jacob was blessed. So the children of Jacob, and continuously the blessing of Abraham continues to flow to today. Because you have given him that mandate, that blessing of intergenerational blessings. Father, O Lord, so I pray tonight that you may locate me with intergenerational anointing, intergenerational blessings. In the name of Jesus Christ, that's it. My Lord and my Father, oh Jesus, I have passed through so much troubles, O Lord. I have passed through so many dry land. But Father, the hour has come that I may begin to pass through a well-watered land. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. For all the years of intergenerational curses, intergenerational poverty, Father, O Lord, replace them with intergenerational blessings. In the name of Jesus. Let intergenerational blessings supersede, overtake, and replace every intergenerational curses or poverty or want that I've been going through in my family. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Every power that wants me to transfer poverty to my children, I command that spirit to expire tonight. Every spirit of poverty that has been flowing like a river in my family, cut the fire and be destroyed today. Forever you shall be destroyed. Forever you are destroyed by the power of the Holy Ghost. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, Holy Father, even now, O God, may you pour blessings upon your people. May you deploy angels of blessings. Let them carry an alabaster jar of oil of blessings, oil of prosperity, oil of wealth upon your people. And let those angels begin to pour upon the heads of everyone hearing my voice now. The oil that you poured upon Abraham, the oil that you poured upon Isaac, that made them to work great and to make them to sow one seed and reap 100 at the end of the year. Let that anointing, let that oil be poured upon my people in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. And therefore now, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let this oil be poured on you. Receive the oil now. Receive the oil now. Oil to increase. Oil to multiply in blessings. Oil to protect your marriage. Oil to grow from strength to strength. Oil to be blessed until others will be blessed from you and through you. In the name of Jesus. Oil, O Lord, to bring all that I have to the house of God. All that I have been given by God to use it to serve him. Oil to bring my talents, my treasure, my time, and use them to serve God. That hour has come. Father, touch your people again. Father, touch your people again. We need a touch of the Master tonight. Father, in this night prayer, that your people have come from different parts of the world to come and pray, O Lord, may you open the floodgate of heaven and pour out your blessings upon your people. Father, let there be no room, O Lord, that will not be covered with the blessings. Let every room, every department of our life and family and destiny be covered with a storehouse of blessings. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, Father, open the windows of heaven again. Let your people begin to receive the rain of favor. In the name of Jesus. Let your people begin to have fruitful, ripening fruits. In the name of Jesus. Father, the hour has come. Touch our people again. Protect our finances, O Lord. Is there any devourer eating our finances? Father, O Lord, devour them tonight. In the name of Jesus, let there be an overflow of blessings. O Robo Shikete, we rebuke the devourer. O Lord, every power devouring our finances, our resources, our destiny, the works of our hands, our sweat. Father, let such power catch fire. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Talk to him now. God is here to bless you. God is here to empower you. God is here to fulfill you. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Pray now, pray now, pray now. As you pray to him, he will answer you. He will infuse upon you a divine DNA. The DNA that attracts favor. The DNA that attracts promotions. The DNA that attracts increase, financial increase. Let that God bless you. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Pray now, pray now, pray now. I don't know what you're believing God for, but I know that God will expand you. I know that God is here to empower you. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. My people, pray now. Pray, don't give up, don't give up. That favor of God is on you. The mercy of God is upon you. Father, Lord, help me, O Lord. I don't want to remain like this again. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Pray, my people, that the grace of God shall be upon you. That the mercy of God shall be upon you. In the name of Jesus. Hell. My people of God, God is talking to us this wonderful night. He has a package for you. And I'm here to decree Genesis chapter 28 verse 3 upon your life, that you shall be blessed in the city and you shall be blessed in the field. That you shall be blessed. That you shall carry a basket of testimonies, a basket of blessings. The Bible says in Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 5 that blessed shall be your basket. And in Deuteronomy chapter 28 verse 3, and the Bible says, and blessed shall be you in the field and you in the city. May God bless you. Oh, the Lord will cause your enemies who rise against you to be defeated because of the blessing is given to you. Be blessed. Be blessed. Even when you are sleeping, be blessed. People that their financial level or power has been buried, may God use the prayer to exhume those buried financial destiny. May they be exhumed now. May they be exhumed now. May they be exhumed now by the power of the Holy Ghost. May they be exhumed now in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, I cover your destiny with the blood of Jesus. Lift up your hand. Just turn your palm of your hand up to heaven, towards heaven. As you turn your palms towards heaven, so I pray, blood of Jesus upon your palms. Let the blood of Jesus remove every signature of shame, signature of poverty that have been inscribed in your palms. May they be destroyed now. In the name of Jesus, every spirit that wants you to be living in debt, may the blood of Jesus eradicate that spirit of debt, of indebtedness, in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, may God remove that spirit of debt that wants you to live a life of being indebted to people. May God help you today in the name of Jesus. May God help you today by the power of his holy name. In the name of Jesus, I speak favor upon you. Business favor. In the name of Jesus, financial favor. May God raise clients for you. In the name of Jesus, people who want to come up with, they have an idea of a certain business, but don't have the finances to go about it, or the connections. And I pray today, may God raise everything to make it possible. May he bring the clients for you. May he bless you mightily. In the name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Before we come to the end of this prayer, I want to share with you the story of one of my friends. This my friend, he gives this testimony himself.
He shares the testimony till today so that people understand that what he is today and who he is today is because God located him in the valley of poverty, the valley of shame. And because he feels proud to share this story, I would therefore share this story with you. And this young man was born in a very poor home. The poverty level was startling. But God had been with him. As a small boy growing up in the local village, he became so sick at a point in his life that he thought he was going to die. In fact, the parents gave up. But he said he saw a man wearing white. And this man told him, "Son, my son, you shall not die. I will use you mightily in the future." So as he was growing up, it was difficult for him. He couldn't go to school. He was struggling with life. He came to the big city, and he couldn't have a place to live. So he was living in the parish. The church would go, everybody would go their home. Then he will stay, he will lie down on the church pews. That was where the parish priest allowed him to be sleeping, because he had no house. So you understand the level of poverty we're talking about. And what he was saying that time is this thing that is called a curry, that is used to cook stew. So can you imagine that somebody, the only thing he's selling in his life was curry? Can you get transport money from curry? I don't know how much curry can do for somebody, sales of curry. Just a small quantity. He'll sell it and go and buy another one. But in spite of what he was going through, in spite of the poverty he was going through, not to mind that he had no finances to support his life, but you know what? God continued to bless him with visions. And God was speaking to him, telling him, "Don't give up. I will bless you one day." Every 12 o'clock, he would go to the church and visit the Blessed Sacrament. He did that for years. Once it's 12 o'clock, 12 noon, he will leave that curry business and he'll go to the church. One day, he had some customers. And now, this is 12 o'clock. And so, he didn't want to leave the customer because, you know, people were buying some curry from him. So, he decided not to go. Now, behold, a customer came, but didn't want to buy. And this customer was standing before him, and he was wondering, which one do you want? How many do you want? And this customer said, "Look, I am waiting for you." He said, "Where?" "I am waiting for you in the place you're supposed to do, a place you're supposed to be by this time. We are supposed to be somewhere at this time. You usually come there, and we meet. Why are you here?" He was just trying to figure out, where am I supposed to be? Then the man disappeared. And then he don't know him. "Oh, I'm supposed to be the Blessed Sacrament." And then he rushed to the Blessed Sacrament. Now let me fast forward this story. Then one day, as he came back from Blessed Sacrament, he saw a polythene bag, at the spot where he keeps his curry. And usually when he leaves to go to the church, he will cover the little business with something. So he came and saw something. And he was wondering, who kept this? He opened it, and what was there was money. So he asked his friends, who dropped this bag? They said, "Nobody came here. Nobody had come here since we were here." So eventually, in the night, he had to pray. He said, "God, I don't understand this kind of temptation. Who brought this money?" And that was when Jesus appeared to him and said, "All this time I've been watching you. And I have seen your faithfulness, and I want to bless you. I am the one who dropped that money for you. I'm not telling you what I read in the book. This is the story of a man. I have his phone number with me. So I'm not telling you what I read in the book. And eventually, God told him, put that money into business. I'm going to multiply it. So he put the business and got a big shop. And people were flooding the business. You know what? The hand of God is inside, how it is. And before that was happening, he got more shops and business was growing until he started having his own apartment. He got a car. As I'm talking to you, he has a ministry, a thriving ministry. He has God already blessed him indeed. That's a house of his own. I mean, so why did I share this with you? To see how God can change the situation of a man. If God would give physical money to this boy, and his hands have been on him, and took him, brought him to where he is today, what can that God do for you? What that God did for him is what God is going to do for those of you who are believing him for a financial breakthrough. What God did for that man, that boy I told you about, that, my friend, is an example of a financial breakthrough. And that is the purpose of the prayer, for God to bring an abundance of financial breakthrough into your life, in the name of Jesus. And so I encourage you to keep trusting the Lord and never to give up. To believe God for all things. To believe that God, who has done it for the people of the old, that he will do it for you, in the name of Jesus. My dear people of God, very importantly, you will notice that even this young man I shared his story with you, he was faithful to God. In spite of the troubles of going through, he was faithful to God. In spite of all the rejections, he was still faithful to God. He kept going to church. He kept attending mass. He kept fasting because he knew that his salvation, his mercy, his help will come from God. And in spite of all that he was going through, he continued to go to the Blessed Sacrament, and God was watching. Many of us don't know that God watches us, and he rewards faithfulness. He rewards faithfulness. Our God himself is faithful, and he rewards those who are faithful to him. So like this young man, I shared his story with you, in which you see a commitment to serving God, a commitment to worshiping God. So God is also talking to us in this very message, in this very 3-day fasting and prayers and seeking the face of God for financial breakthrough. God is also calling us into commitment, into faithfulness, into life of faithfulness. God is calling us to live a life of holiness. For without holiness, no one can see the face of God. So we need God to bless us. We need God to help us to live the life of holiness, the life of faithfulness. And this is what God is calling us to do, not just within these 3 days of prayers, and not just within these days of the fast and prayers that the ministry is going through now, but all through our lives, that God is calling us into a life of holiness, a life of faithfulness, no grudges, no compromise of integrity, that God have trusted you for certain things. Let us live in line with what God wants us to live in. We are asking him to help us to live a life that is pleasing to him. It is very important for us to understand that as the ministry is going through a grand 40 days of fasting and prayers, that while this local fasting and prayers of 3 days is taking place in the more encompassing 40 days of fasting and prayers, that God will use all these prayers to package you, to position you in a way that you will know indeed that you have not wasted your time to pray. And so we are obliged to remind ourselves that we will continue to seek the face of God, that we will continue to love God and to believe in his word and promises to us, that we shall not complain about anything. Instead, when faced with unpleasant situations, we shall continue to see reasons to praise Him. And we shall not grudge or not even to judge people. Let us rather look inwards and ask God, where do I need to improve? What do I need to shed out of my life? We need to shed a lot of things off from our lives. From tomorrow, we're praying to shed things out of our lives that are blocking blessings. There are a lot of things that can stop blessings from coming. We are praying for increase, financial increase, but a thing that can block it. Tomorrow we'll be dealing with that and asking God to deliver us from such selfishness and such spirits or fleshly works that can delay or withhold or interrupt our blessings. And so as we do this, God is going to help us to be strong in Him, that we shall be focusing on God, not on the weaknesses or shortcomings of others, but that we shall in everything find reasons to praise God, even in the life of people that have been so hard on us. Also, we shall not use what God has given to us to disgrace or to bring a scandal to the house of God. How do I bring scandal to the house of God? When God has given me gifts and I'm using that gift selfishly, it is a scandal in the house of God. Amen? So God is talking to us in these areas so that we'll be able to know that as we do our own part and as we seek to be better people, God will help us indeed to be the people He wants to see in us, in the name of Jesus. Again, and just to remind us, we should not hold grudges, and if anybody has offended you, do forgive that person for your own good, so that we shall be blessed, so that we shall not allow the devil in whatever way to take away our blessings or to give reason for our blessing to be delayed. May the Holy Spirit give each one of us the grace to follow Him, to follow His plan for us, and as we follow Him, God will continue to bless us mightily in the name of Jesus. And so I lift up my hand up at you, that the grace of God will be with you, that the mercy of God will be with you, that God will empower you the more, that God who has given you these blessings shall keep your blessings in your life in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord, I pray everything that God has promised in Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1 to 14 into your life. I pray that God will sustain the new economy in your life in the name of Jesus. May you be a citizen of a new economy in the name of Jesus. Mighty God, we thank you. Thank you, Father, for giving us prosperity in every area of our lives. We come in to listen to your voice and to continue to seek your word in the name of Jesus. Mighty God, thank you that no matter how bad things are now, we know that you are taking us to a new realm of increase, of abundance. Thank you, mighty Jesus, that our hands are going to touch favor in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for making us heirs to your blessings. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for making us channels through which blessings will flow to others. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, according to your word, to stand in unshakable faith based on your word, ready to receive from you and to share what you have given abundantly. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. Thank you for multiplying my seed that I have sown in the ground so that I will have great harvest. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Jesus, Father, thank you. Your word says that He who ministers seed to the sower, both ministers bread for my food and multiplies my seed sown and increases the fruits of my righteousness. Therefore, I am enriched in everything to all bountifulness in the name of Jesus. And I give you thanksgiving, Lord, for what you have done in the course of the prayer. Thank you, mighty Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Blessed be your name. We appreciate you, Lord, for what you have done is permanent, and your blessings cannot be taken away. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Jesus, we cover this prayer with the blood of Jesus. We cover the blessings we have received with the blood of Jesus. And we cover this ministry with the blood of Jesus. will cover our brother and his ministry and life and job with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, El Shaddai. Thank you, Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Blessed be your name. Thank you for what I've done tonight. I invite you to begin to thank him, just to thank him for what he has done, that God has touched you tonight, that God has started great things in your financial life through this prayer. He who has increased you will continue to sustain that increase so that you shall not decrease. In the name of Jesus, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. And so we cover this prayer with the blood of Jesus Christ and we decree that no power, no attack against this prayer shall prosper. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Every devourer that have been cast out, we decree that they shall not come back. All the spirits devouring our blessings that have been cast out, we decree they shall not come back. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. With Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. If there's an intercessor, can they quickly pray over brother for just 2 minutes or less. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
King of glory, we call upon your name this day, Father, Lord, as you've empowered him to bless us, your family. Our Lord and our God, may you continue to bless him. Walk in his vineyard, merciful Lord. Father, as you've used him to enrich your children tonight, King of glory, may you enrich him. Our Lord and our God, as you've used him to fight out every devourer that has been holding back the prosperity of your children, my Lord and my God. Father, Lord, may you walk in his vineyard too, merciful God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Everlasting King of glory, our Lord and our God. Christ Jesus died, O Lord, even though in poverty, so that through his poverty we too shall experience wealth. King of glory, may it be so with your son you've used mightily tonight. Our Lord and our God, may he experience the power and the working of God in his life. May he be empowered, Father, in everything he does to lift you up, King of glory, to testify to the awesomeness of our Father and our God. King of glory, use him mightily. Father, Lord, he walks mightily in your vineyard, everlasting King of peace. Bless him. Bless him, O Lord. Bless him, merciful Father. Bless him, our Lord and our God. Bless him, mightily King of glory. We saturate him with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. We soak him with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. We infuse him with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. And may the power of God Almighty be and abide upon him, King of glory, now and forever. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.